हेलो फ्रेंड्स, केजी क्लासेस में आपका स्वागत है। आज हम आपको फिलिप लार्किन 1922-1985 के लॉन्ग आंसर के बारे में बताएंगे। क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट, राइट ए क्रिटिकल एप्रिसिएशन ऑफ चर्च गोइंग। आंसर हेडिंग इंट्रोडक्शन। चर्च गोइंग इज वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट पोएम्स ऑफ फिलिप लार्किन, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिस्टिंग्विश्ड पोएट ऑफ इंग्लैंड। In this poem, he refers to man's indifference towards religion and his disliking for going to the religious places for worship and for listening to the sermons. He points out that this would end and faith would be revived. Heading a his firm faith. The poet has firm faith in the utility of religion and in the efficacy of the church. He has a strong belief that one day superstitions would disappear just as belief has disappeared, but the disbelief will also disappear. Faith will be duly restored. The church would never become useless. The religious ceremonies would never become obsolete. People would never give up faith in God. Someone will be strongly drawn towards the church on his leaving, having heard from his elders that church is a place wherein wisdom is gained and accumulated. Thus, one will inspire other, and the other will inspire many others, and that way the process will continue forever. Adding a church, the symbol of compulsion, aspirations. In the opinion of the poet, church will become to be the symbol of people's compulsion and aspirations. Human destinies will remain enshrined in it. The poet takes both the religion and the church seriously and expresses his frank opinion that any sort of indifference to the church, that is to say to the religion, is detriment to the health of the people. It cannot last long. It will discuss one day. Heading a style. Poet's narrative style is very outstanding. There is regular flow in the narration. The reader's interest is never sagging. By using the first person singular for the narration, the poet has given greater significance to the poem. The examples which he gives of dubious women, ruin, babbler, and Christmas addict are highly picturesque and suggestive. Heading a poetic imagery. The description of the interior of the church is highly pictorial. Everything is described in detail. The matting, seat, stone, and little books, sprawling of flowers, bronze, now some brass and stuff up at the holy end, the small neat organ and a tense, musty, unignorable silence is a beautiful description. It is the example of beautiful, visual, sensuous, poetic imagery. The second stanza is also full of visual, poetic, imaginative power. Heading a modernism. The poet has described the mental condition of man emphatically by using the first person singular. The cynicism, skepticism of modern man has been explained. The condition of suspense and anxiety of modern man is explained plainly. Even in the use of poetic imagery, King has used the modern terms ruin, rubber, rude, left, Christmas addict, gone and bands, and open organ pipes are such expression. Adding a conclusion, church going is one of the best example of the modern poetry. It denotes poet's faith in God, in church, and such other institutions. Modern cynicism and skepticism will not last forever. Faith would be revived belief would inspire once more and will continue to do forever. Question second, discuss Philip Larkin as a poet. Heading a introduction. Philip Larkin is one of the most remarkable poets of England. He is a modern poet. He has 10 novels. Also, his two novels, Jill and A Girl in Winter, are widely read and admired. All What Jazz In is his book on music. Larkin is a serious poet and has full faith in God and his divinity. He explained the cynicism and skepticism of modern man, but concludes that faith would be revived and beliefs would keep on inspiring mankind for ages to come. Larkin is a poet with a message inspiring mankind for ages to come. Larkin is a poet with a message behind the veneer of cynicism and skepticism. There shines brilliantly a ray of hope in his poetry. He is a man of convictions and a poet with all the seriousness of a devoted man. Heading a North Ship. The North Ship is the first collection of his poems. Its intrinsic value has never been questioned ever since its publication in 1945. Its importance was so widely felt that after its first publication, it has had several influences. Elizabeth Jennings remarked, "It is good to know that Larkin could write so well when still so young." Adding a high windows. The second collection of his poems is entitled High Windows. It appeared in 1964. Ever since its publication, its popularity has grown constantly and steadily. It is a collection of poems in which all the well-known virtue and skills of the poet are increased, validated, and drawn together by the ethereal and compelling image providing the title of the volume. In this volume, all the different Larkin motifs have come together in preciously adjusted balance. Heading a Whitsome Weddings. The Whitsome Weddings contains 32 poems, of which 10 are among his best and certainly among the best poems of the modern age. They move broadly from a common area of concern, but between them they come across a whole emotional human landscape. The volume contains compassion, violence, humor, love, and a sense of order and a sense of best. The poem reveals the finally imaged and expressed distillations of a remarkable poetic personality. Heading his outlook. Philip Larkin is temperamentally and geographically remote. He has refused almost all invitations to judge, to recite, review, lecture, pontificate, or be interviewed. He has continued to produce poems of his literary value. He is read all over the world with great avidity. His poems are finding place in almost all the standard anthologies published all over the world. Conclusion. Philip Larkin is both poet and novelist and has written on music also. He has described himself as a great literary force in England and also outside England. He is one of the most remarkable poets of the English language. Short answer type question. Question first, what is the central idea of the church going? Answer, the central idea of the church going is that modern cynicism and skepticism will take place of faith and belief. Mankind thrives on beliefs. It cannot survive without faith and beliefs. Time and again, someone would come out from amongst the multitude to inspire mankind and revive faith in God and God's divinity. Question second, write a short note on Philip Larkin as a poet, or what are the main features of the poetry of Philip Larkin? Answer, Philip Larkin is one of the most well-known modern poets. He has written novels and many wonderful poems. He is a serious poet who has full faith in God. He describes the cynicism of modern man. He is a poet who wants to give a message to the human beings that without the spiritual power one cannot progress. In his poems, again and again, he points out that spiritual progress is the greatest progress for human life. His narrative style is very interesting. Question third, what aspect of modern poems life has been highlighted in the poem Church Going? Answer, the poem Church Going, the best point out that the modern man is becoming a rational man. He is now more attracted towards sins than towards God. A great change has come in the common life of modern people and they do not feel peace in church. Objective type question. Philip Larkin was born in answer 1922. Question, Philip Larkin died in answer 1985. Third, by profession Larkin was a answer musician. Question, the North Shift by Larkin was first published in answer 1945. Question, Philip Larkin was answer both poet and novelist. Question, which of the following is not by Larkin? Answer, Look Stranger. Question, which of the following novels is not by Larkin? Answer, Lord Jim. Question, the poet denoted at the church on Iris. Answer, Sixpence. Question, devious women will come to the church to make their children touch a answer particular stone. Question, Philip Larkin is hopeful that one day faith will be answered duly restored. Thanks, best of luck.